cause any pain. This cocksucker's got to suffer. We'll stuff him full of that shite he told Edric to eat.
Hey, look.
What do you want?
Want to talk to the Pellar?
Too late. We've got dibs on a chat with him. A long one.
Get the hell out. Now.
And here I thought we'd have a day without corpses.
Herb Majors pay top coin for the special bits of rare creatures. Wonder how much we'll get for his eyes.
Form a row!
Go on,
stand
go
still,
on.
Dammit!
Gotta wonder about a man who could get Edric's friends all worked up.
Hey, anybody home? Open up, it's safe now.
Devils, who do they bring? What seek ye?
I need your help.
Ooh, a man, nay, a wolf, grey, though not old. 'Tis he the Pellar awaits.
Expecting me.
Aye, as the bones declared I should. They shall come whose stench is rape and death, but the wolf shall disperse them, the white wolf. And thus he comes. Omens never lie.
Recognize this? Made of spruce wood, strong smell of juniper, designed to protect someone.
Freshly cut spruce, sprinkled with goat's blood, then tempered with an incense of earth, smoke, and juniper. For Anna, to protect her.
So, designed to protect her. From what?
Oh, the dear. Besieged she was, evil all around, wanting to possess her. Old magic, born of oblivion, from dark sources emerged.
Old magic? Can you be more specific?
It is not for mouth speech, nor for the touch. A small protective charm, not a thing more a Pellar could do.
You make the amulet?
Aye, sure 'twas the Pellar. After the way of his forefathers, over still water in the light of a full moon. Proper as amulets go. It protected well. Should never have taken it off.
Anna and her daughter are missing. Know where they are?
Nay, no, nay. Pellar don't know. But the spirits could know. The Pellar will augur, the spirits ask.
Spirits? Great. Fine with me. Long as I know where to look, where to find them.
Lost, lost. Must be found. Princess! None better than princess for finding things.
Princess? Which princess?
Princess! My goat! She's fled!
Those men must have scared her off. Can we get back to the auguring?
Without the goat? Impossible. No goat? Won't work.
Will you help me if I bring the goat back?
Princess! Princess! Where have you got to, girl?
Fine. I'll get your goat.
The bell! The little bell's ringing! She loves it! Ring, ring, and she will follow. But for a while. But beware of wild strawberries. Raspberries, too.
Yeah, treacherous as beasts go. I always keep an eye out for them. Here, goat. Here, princess. Hoofed and horned. Should have known it would be stubborn. All right, time to try the bell.
Come on, let's go see
you back to the Pellar. Misses you something awful.
Do I really have to keep ringing this bell for you to follow? Come on, damn it. Where the hell'd you go?
This area. Good thing I ran into him earlier.
Do I really have to keep ringing this bell for you to follow?
You're no roach, but I bet we can be friends in time. You've got that all-important quality every roach has to have. You don't talk much.
Pro-
Princess! Flee not from the Pellar, for there are wolves about. Goat of mine! Dearest, sweetest goat!
Happy for you, but I'm kinda in a hurry. Anna and Tamara, they might be in danger.
The White Wolf helped the Pellar, and so the Pellar shall help him. Blood! We need blood! A living being!
Fine. Be right back. Will this do? Mentioned a child. Whose?
Why, Anna's.
Anna was pregnant?
She was. And she miscarried.
Baron didn't mention it.
Afraid, perhaps. Or ashamed, or forgetful. Or perhaps he had no wish to remember.
The Baron have anything to do with his wife's miscarriage?
Foul-tempered he is. And he's a fondness for hooch.
No doubt makes his temper even fouler. Did he abuse his family? Anna came to you. You must have noticed something.
The Pellar's old, near blind. But Princess came and licked her hand.
So what?
She's a wise beast. Only comes to those who suffer.
What happened to the child?
In a grave thrown. Without rite or ceremony, it awoke. Now it wanders. It seeks vengeance.
A botchling.
White Wolf, wise wolf, catch the botchling. The botchling will help. Lead the wolf to the loved ones.
Botchlings suck the blood of pregnant women and eat their fetuses. They don't help.
'Tis a being cursed, and witches lift curses. If the White Wolf can't lift it, he should bring me its blood. Blood will always find kindred blood.
Why do you want its blood?
Blood, blood, blood. It binds men for all ages, the living and the dead.
Sure, but what do you want to do with it?
At times, a century is too short for two brothers to reconcile. One dies before things are set right. The other then brings his blood to the Pellar.
And what does the Pellar do?
He awaits Forefather's Eve. He mixes the blood with milk, herbs, and hen's feet. He drinks to reconcile the dead with the living. There shall be no Forefather's Eve this year, but we'll find a way, all the same.
Heard of one witcher who lifted a botchling's curse. Never tried it myself, though. I know you need to bury it under the threshold.
And give it a name. Perform the I'm Roin.
The ritual of naming? That's an elven custom.
Human, elven, dwarven, ancient. Spirits have no race. They honor not its meaning. Win a spirit's favor, and the spirit shall aid you. Ask, and it will answer. Seek, and it will show you the way.
I hear you right. You mentioned Forefather's Eve. Pretty old custom. Thought it had died out.
Death lurks in every bog and puddle round here. Folk know they could die, their earthly matters unresolved. Then they require help, or they'll not know peace. Forefather's Eve must be performed. Light the tallow candles to lead them through the dark. Call them by name, appease their regrets. Only then may they depart in peace.
Whatever I do, I gotta find the botchling first.
Seek it at midnight, near the grave that lies empty.
If what you say is true, the Baron ought to know where that grave is.
Whoever finds the Baron's daughter will not go unrewarded.
Greetings.
Salutations! Whither do you come from, and where will you go?
Hard to say. Seen a lot of the world and plan to see more.
As have I, as do I.
Not the best place for a traveling peddler.
Profits lie amidst risk. True, the wars brought strife and hardship, but folk live on, and where there is life, there is trade.
Prepared to risk your life for a bit of coin?
Coin, my friend, is of little import. Hard as I try, I simply cannot remain still, so I wander and wander the world. I see new places, speak with folk I've never known. It's what I like, and that's worth the risk.
Take a peek, if you don't mind. Farewell.
We'll meet again. I know this.
Baron gets soused. He gets angry.
Come on, James! Double quick! Fast as farts! Go at it!
Strike.
Oswin? Where's Oswin? Anyone seen him?
Believe I saw him heading to the stable.
What?
Fire. You blind? Nobody willing to put it out?
Ain't that simple. Most are afraid. Baron flies into a rage. He takes no prisoners.
My brother's in the stable. We've got to save him. He'll burn alive. Him and the horses.
See what I can do.
Hurry now, quick!
hide!
Set the stables afire!
Oswin? Where's Oswin? Anyone seen him?
Believe I saw him heading to the stable.
What?
Fire. You blind? Nobody willing to put it out?
Ain't that simple. Most are afraid. Baron flies into a rage. He takes no prisoners.
My brother's in the stable. We've got to save him. He'll burn alive. Him and the horses.
See what I can do.
Hurry now, quick!
Why, I'm prepared to forgive you the drubbing you gave those pricks at the crossroads.
I know your wife miscarried. Was that before or after you beat her to a pulp?
What the fuck are you suggesting?
Don't play me for a fool. You'd been beating them for years. Finally, they'd had enough and fled. Sound about right? They ran from you, didn't they?
Lying prick!
Sit down. You beat them.
I never laid a finger on Tamara. Not once.
And on Anna?
That's another story. She always knew how to spark my ire.
Expect me to believe you are a loving father to Tamara after that scene in the courtyard?
You're free to believe whatever you wish. But she was always the apple of my eye. She had the run of the place, ask anyone. She'd ride the horses, hunt with the men, at times join them on their rounds. And they'd send for her when I flew into a rage.
for only she could calm me.
Make it sound like she led a charmed life. If that's the case, why'd she run?
I'd hardly need you if I knew.
Your wife? How'd she make you angry? Too much salt in the soup? Socks never darned?
20 years we've known each other. She's seen me drunk and sober. She was there to greet me when I returned the victor. She was there to patch me up in defeat. Like no other, she knew where to press, where to pinch, so it would hurt.
You beat her? For that? For criticizing you?
Oh, Witcher, you haven't a clue, have you? Well, perhaps I shall tell you about it one day. One day, but not today.
You knew they had run away from the start.
Yes, I knew.
Why didn't you tell me? Wasted my time.
Say I had. Say I'd said I had troubles. Couldn't control my wife, my daughter. What kind of flaccid prick would you take me for?
Tell me everything you remember about the day they fled. The truth this time.
I'd been soaking myself 3 days straight. Anna came to me, said they were leaving. I begged them to stay. She refused to hear it. I tried to stop her. She wriggled like an eel. We struggled. She fell. Last blasted thing I remember. Woke up in the morn, breeches heavy with my own piss. A large bump on my head. Sadly, they were gone. Know what that's like, Witcher? No. How the fuck could you? I was left with nothing. Nothing! Only the bottle.
Signs of a fight in the room. Hole in the wall, wine all over the landing. Was that you?
Aye. We tussled. She tried to whack me on the noggin with a candlestick, but kept missing. Hit the wall and a pillar instead. I staggered backwards onto the table. Spilled the wine, slipped and tumbled. Anna used that moment to flee. She rushed down the stairs, still clutching that damn candlestick. I caught her on the landing. We fell. I thought I had her. Then she turned and smacked me in the head. I blacked out. Don't know what happened next. When I came to, I was alone.
Tamara present for all this? She see you quarrel?
Through the doorway, perhaps. She didn't enter the room. Shame, too. Things might have turned out differently. The sight of her always calmed me.
What happened next?
Next? It only got worse. I awoke at sunset, not knowing how many days had passed. Thought it was all a ploughing, drunken nightmare. And then I went to the bedchamber. But Anna was not there. Instead, there was blood everywhere. I knew she'd miscarried. My breath short, my throat locked. I neared the bed and saw it. It lay there, a tiny thing, defenseless. On bloodied sheets. Dead. And it was my doing.
Seen a lot of dead in my time, but that must have been hard.
Unspeakably so. My legs gave out. I saw fields of corpses at Sodden. Saw witches burn in Maribor. But compared to this, all that was a rabbit's prick alongside a great oak. And the guilt is all mine.
We don't know that yet. The amulet and a war could be linked somehow. Maybe the fact that she lost it. What did you do with the child?
Wrapped it in a clean sheet and buried it.
Just like that?
Damn you! I gave no thought to a funeral. It was a horror. I wanted it to end. That child had been my dream. I told Anna, the little one, our little one, to make things right. Yet she died before she could be born. Understand, Witcher. My child was dead.
I sympathize. I do.
Thank you. And know that I hope you find your Ciri.
Deal we made means I need to find Tamara and Anna first. Just so happens your unborn daughter might help us do that.
What? How?
Sometimes miscarried fetuses, if they don't get a proper burial, turn into botchlings.
Into fucking what?
Details you don't need to know. There's a bond of blood between this creature and your wife and daughter. I can use that bond to find them.
How?
One of two ways. Legends claim you can bury a botchling under the family's threshold, perform a ritual, and turn it into a lubberkin. That's a sort of, hob, a guardian spirit that could lead me to your family.
And the other way?
We kill it and draw some blood. Take that to the Pellar and he does the rest.
Do not kill my child. It's suffered enough already. Lift the curse that it may finally rest in peace.
Whatever we do, we gotta find the botchling first.
I'll show you where I buried her, and I'll dig the grave at my threshold.
If it turns out we can't transform the botchling into a lubberkin, they can bury us in it. Handy either way.